In part two of our video lesson on angles, we're going to talk about converting between degrees, minutes, and seconds, and decimal degrees. Look at this first example. The way you would read this is 49 degrees, 13 minutes, and 10 seconds. So a single degree gets divided into smaller parts, which are called minutes and seconds. So let's take a look at the relationships between degrees, minutes, and seconds. So 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, which then means that 1 minute would be 1/60th of a degree. Now, an angle then gets divided up into 60 equal parts, and each of those parts is called 1 minute. Now, the 1 minute gets further divided into 60 equal parts called seconds. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, which means 1 second is 1/60th of a minute. Now, if there's 60 minutes in 1 degree and 60 seconds in each minute, then that means there's 60 times 60, which is 3,600 seconds in 1 degree. So then converting the other way means that 1 second is equal to 1/3,600 of a degree. So that's the fraction of a degree it is. So now let's take a look at this example where we are being asked to convert the angle measure from degrees, minutes, and seconds into decimal degrees. Now, we know that because we have 38 full degrees, that the decimal equivalent is going to be 38 point something degrees, and this is what we're going to figure out. Now we have 15 minutes, and we know that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, so we can use that conversion factor. We want to go from minutes to decimal degrees, so we want to put the 1 degree in the numerator and the 60 minutes in the denominator, because we want to cancel out the units of minute with the units of minute. Now we know that 15 will go into 60 four times, which means this would be 1/4 of a degree, which we know then would be 0.25 degrees. So 15 minutes is the same as 0.25 degrees. Now let's look at the 45 seconds. So 45 seconds, we know the conversion factor here. We have to go to degrees from seconds. So we know that 1 degree is 3,600 seconds. So that's the conversion factor we'll use. And of course, seconds will cancel in the numerator here with seconds in the denominator. So doing the division, 45 divided by 3,600 is equal to 0.0125 degrees. So 45 seconds of angle is equivalent to 0.0125 degrees. So to find out the decimal portion of our answer, we will take those two and add them up. We have 0.25 plus 0.0125. We know we have to line up the decimal points and fill in with zeros. bring the decimal point straight down, and then add vertically. 0 plus 5 is 5, 0 plus 2 is 2, 5 plus 1 is 6, and 2 plus 0 is 0. So this will be the decimal portion of our answer, 0.2625. This is in degrees. So 38 degrees, 15 minutes, 45 seconds is equal to 38.2625 degrees, and that's what we mean when we call it decimal degrees. In this next example, we have to convert the angle measure from decimal degrees into degrees, minutes, and seconds. So we're going in the opposite direction. Now, because we have 144.251, that means we know we have 144 full degrees. And now what we're going to need to do is convert the 0.251 degrees into minutes and seconds. So we use our conversion factor. We know that 1 degree is 60 minutes. So we're going to put the 1 degree in the denominator this time because those are the units we want to cancel out. And we want to end up in minutes. So we need the units of minutes in the numerator. If we take our calculator and multiply 0.251 times 60, we get 15.06 minutes. Now, what that tells us is that we get 15 full minutes. So we can put that up here in our answer. And then we still have 0.06 minutes that we need to convert into seconds. So now the relationship between minutes and seconds is that 1 minute is 60 seconds, so we'll use that conversion. So we have in the denominator 1 minute, and in the numerator we put 60 seconds, and we find that if we multiply 0.06 times 60, we're going to get 3.6 seconds. Now what we do at this point, we don't have any units smaller than seconds, so we're going to go ahead and round at this point. And we'll write it as 4 seconds. And that will come up here in our final answer. So what we just discovered is that 144.251 degrees is equal to 144 degrees, 15 minutes, and 4 seconds. In the next three examples, we're going to perform each addition or subtraction without using a calculator. Now we have to subtract 23 degrees 14 minutes minus 11 degrees 25 minutes. So just like you did in your arithmetic classes, we need to line everything up. 23 degrees 14 minutes. We're going to subtract 11 degrees 25 minutes. You see that we have a problem because we can't take 25 minutes away from 14 minutes. But if you remember that every degree has 60 minutes in it, then we can borrow. So we can turn this 23 degrees into 22 degrees 60 minutes, and then we can add that 60 minutes to the 14 minutes. So then this will become 22 degrees, and 60 plus 14 minutes is 74 minutes, and we're subtracting 11 degrees 25 minutes. Now we can do this subtraction and we'll do the normal borrowing that you've always done. You can't take 5 away from 4, so the 7 will become a 6, and the 4 becomes a 14. So 14 minus 5, we get 9. 6 minus 2 is 4, so there's 49 minutes. 2 minus 1 is 1, and same here, 2 minus 1 is 1. So our answer is 11 degrees and 49 minutes. In the next example, we have to subtract 70 minus 27 degrees, 42 minutes, and 13 seconds. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. We've got 70 degrees minus 27 degrees, 42 minutes, 13 seconds. You notice that we don't have any minutes or seconds with the 70, so we're going to have to borrow. So the 70 degrees becomes 69 degrees and 60 minutes. Then next, we're going to need to borrow 1 minute from here and turn it into 60 seconds here. So then the 60 minutes becomes 59 minutes and 60 seconds. And now we're able to do the subtraction. 60 minus 13 we know is 47 seconds. 59 minus 42 is going to be 17 minutes. And 69 minus 27 is going to be 42 degrees. So there's our answer. 42 degrees, 17 minutes, 47 seconds. And we had to borrow twice in this problem. We took the 70, turned it into 69 degrees, 60 minutes. Then we took the 60 minutes and turned it into 59 degrees, 60 seconds. In this third example, we're adding two angle measures. So we have 58 degrees, 29 minutes, plus 13 degrees, 45 minutes. All right. Now, when we add 9 plus 5, we get 14. Carry the 1. So we get 4 and 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7. Now, over in the degree columns, 8 plus 3 is 11. Carry the 1. We have 5 plus 1 plus 1, so we get 7. So we have 71 degrees, 74 minutes. Now, you can't leave an answer where the number of minutes is greater than 60. So remember that 60 minutes is equal to 1 degree. So we're going to subtract 60 minutes from here and add that 1 minute to here so that our final answer, the number of minutes, will be 74. We're taking away 60 of those, so that's going to be 14 minutes. Think of this in two parts. We're adding the 1 degree to the 71 degrees to get 72 degrees. So 71 degrees, 74 minutes is the same thing as having 72 degrees, 14 minutes. And there's our solution.